What's going on, everybody? Anoush Kashefi here from dropshipsniper.com, and in this video I have something special for you. We're going to be talking about the major differences between retail arbitrage and online arbitrage and how I've been able to use online arbitrage to generate over six figures per month on Amazon, all right? And if you stick around to the end of the video, I'm going to give you the number one secret that I have for you so you can build your very own six-figure business on Amazon, all right? So we're going to get down to it. Let's get this. Here we go, folks. So the first thing I want to do is break down the differences of the two easiest ways to make money on Amazon in 2018. Okay, the first method that we're going to be talking about is retail arbitrage, but then we're going to talk about online arbitrage. That's the method that I use to generate over six figures per month on Amazon. Okay, so what the heck are these different methods? Retail arbitrage is when you, and I have some quick definitions I just threw up here, physically walk into the stores and find products that you can sell on Amazon for a profit. Okay, so what you're going to be doing with retail arbitrage is you will literally walk into places like Walmart or Toys R Us or even random shops, right? And if they have products that you think are going to be profitable, you can scan those barcodes. You can literally scan the barcodes in your Amazon app and find out what that item is selling for on Amazon and see if you can make a profit on that product. So for example, you might scan a product inside of Walmart that is selling for $50 and it's telling you that it's being sold for on Amazon for $100, okay? So what you can then do is take those products that you purchase physically at Walmart, bring them home, and you can do two methods. You can either ship them and fulfill them yourself. So this would be fulfillment by merchant, FBM, versus FBA, where you can take those products, and this is a great way to start getting into FBA, okay? A lot of people think you need to go over to China and buy in bulk thousands of units. You don't have to do that to get into FBA. What you can do is you can walk into these big box stores, purchase some inventory that you see you're gonna make a profit on, and then take those products, ship them into FBA, and have Amazon do all the heavy lifting as far as shipping those items to your customers, customer service, and all the stuff that goes into the FBA program, the fulfillment by Amazon program, okay? So that's retail arbitrage. You're physically walking into the store, you're going to purchase the products yourself, and then you can either list them on Amazon yourself. You're going to list them on Amazon and you can sell them yourself, fulfill them yourself, get them, you know, drop them off at UPS once the order comes in, add the tracking into Amazon yourself, or you can have Amazon do that by shipping it into the fulfillment warehouses and have them fulfill it for you. That's retail arbitrage versus online arbitrage. What the heck is this? This is my bread and butter, folks. This is what I love. I'm super passionate about online arbitrage, and it's because it kind of brings together retail arbitrage with, like, you know, everything is melded together. You get all the benefits of retail arbitrage and none of the cons. Okay, so what are the major cons to retail arbitrage? Obviously, you have to physically walk into these shops and find these products. You need to scan these products and find out if they're profitable, which takes a lot of time. I know people will go and spend hours and hours scanning products at these stores to find out if they can find some profits. Okay, on top of that, you're now taking these physical products to your home and you have to either ship them or ship them into the FBA warehouse. So there's a lot of hands-on. It's a very physical business. Some people love it. It's just not what I'm into, okay? Either of these methods can make you a lot of money. I know there's people on YouTube like Greasy Resells. He does retail arbitrage and he crushes it, okay? Super cool dude from what I know from his videos. But, you know, he does retail arbitrage and crushes it. It's just not what I'm into. And so versus online arbitrage is where you can sit at home at the comfort of your home. You know, if you work in your office, wherever you want to work, Starbucks down the street, you can fire up your computer, fire up your tools, and start finding these profitable products that are going to be shipped directly from your US-based supplier to your customer's doorstep. Okay, so this, as I mentioned, it takes out a lot of the cons of the retail arbitrage. Okay, so, like, for example, you don't have to physically touch any products. You don't have to warehouse any products. You don't have to leave your house to start finding profits. You don't have to scan a single barcode, which is very time consuming. You don't even have to worry about, hey, where do I ship this? Do I have to ship this? Any of that stuff, okay? You still do need to worry about the tracking numbers and getting the tracking number into Amazon system on time. So here's how the process works with online arbitrage. The order comes into your store. You will go and purchase that product from your supplier and you simply copy and paste the customer's information into your supplier's website and it will get shipped to your customer's doorstep, as mentioned, and your supplier will ship it. You don't have to worry about shipping. So why are these two methods the fastest, easiest methods to start your Amazon business in 2018? Well, the number one reason, guys, is because you only need $100. You don't even really need $100. You could start with $50. You could buy one product for, let's say, $20 on Walmart, and if it's selling for $40 on Amazon, you're gonna be able to make a profit there, potentially, right? You're gonna have to do a little bit of research, and that's what this is all about. But the whole point, guys, is you don't need $1 million to start an Amazon business. You don't need to purchase products from China. You can start with $100. You can walk into Walmart and start doing some retail arbitrage as soon as today, right now, okay? On top of that, you can start doing online arbitrage with the same amount, $100. Now, you need to keep in mind, guys, when you start a brand new account on Amazon, they will tend to hold your funds just to verify who you are. They're gonna hold your funds for 2 weeks. So while it's going to be a little bit long to scale up your business when you start with $100 or less, you're still starting an Amazon business, okay? And you're going to be able to build up sales, put the profit back into your business, and start a real Amazon store, okay? So don't make this as difficult as everyone else makes it out to be. Decide if you want to go with retail arbitrage, physically walking into these stores and finding products that you can sell for a profit. One little tip for you guys is download the application. There's an Amazon seller app that you can get, and you can start scanning these barcodes to see exactly what the product that you scanned is selling for on Amazon, all right? So definitely, if you're gonna do some retail arbitrage, grab that application and start scanning. Even if you go out and you're hanging out with a family, or you just go buy some shoes at, you know, DSW or something like that, just go and start scanning stuff. You know, take 5 minutes. Every now and then, you know, I'm not a big scanner, I'm not a big retail arbitrage guy, but every now and then I see something. Like, I was at Walmart the other day, and I never really even shop at Walmart. I was at Target the other day, and there was this big, huge charcoal smoker that was on clearance. That's another tip I have for you. If you're gonna do retail arbitrage, look at the clearance sections, and be sure to dig into those, because I saw this thing on clearance. It was a big, huge barbecue, and that was the only reason I didn't move on it. I didn't know what the shipping was going to cost me, but it was literally selling for $50, and I could have sold it for like $110, okay? So there's definitely meat on the bone. I just was concerned about the shipping rates, okay? And this is one thing that, you know, I'm not very good at. Plus, I don't want to store a bunch of stuff at my house. So that's why I lean towards online arbitrage, and I just focus all my energy on finding products on the computer, and I don't do any scanning, okay? But if you're gonna do scanning, grab the app and do it the right way, okay? So now, I wanted to share with you guys how I was able to generate six figures through the power of online arbitrage, okay? And the secret that I have for you that I want to share with you guys is that you have to, in either one of these methods, you have to focus on hot selling products, okay? On Amazon, it's all about the bestseller rank, okay? And every single product on Amazon is listed with the bestseller rank if it's selling, okay? So you can go search right now. Let's just hop over here right now. I'll just click this right here, and we can click this product and see what is the bestseller rank for this product. So the bestseller rank is gonna tell us exactly how well the product is selling on Amazon, okay? And so the lower the number, the better, okay? And we can see this right here. Amazon best sellers rank, 540 in clothing. So as I said, the number one bestseller is the number one bestseller in that category on Amazon. So you want to list hot selling products. Let's keep this number under 100,000 if possible. So when you're scanning products, doing retail arbitrage, or you know, you're doing some online retail arbitrage or online arbitrage, what you want to look for is make sure these products that you want to list, if you're going to go list something and do some retail arbitrage, make sure it's selling, okay? So look for the bestseller rank to be under 100,000. That's not set in stone. Of course, if you find a product that is, you know, under 200,000, that's still a good sales rank. It just means it's selling a lot less, okay? So that's the thing here, guys. Try to focus on hot selling products. This is how you can build an awesome store that works for you. Literally, I have products on my store that I sell 300 or 400 times a month, and they sit on my store and they just work for me around the clock, okay? And this is what I want for you. In order for you to do that, you have to focus on the hot selling products, the best seller rank that is, let's say, below 200,000. And as I mentioned, you can find out the best seller rank for any product that you may want to list by just clicking it, coming down here, and if it's selling, you'll see something that says best seller rank somewhere around here. Here you go, best sellers rank. So 3,500, this means this is selling extremely well. If you found a product that you could find, you know, retail arbitrage or online arbitrage that you're going to be able to make a profit on, let's say you find it at Walmart for $50 and you can sell it for $100 and you see a sales rank like this, Well, that's a really good start, guys, because this is a super hot selling product. Anything under 100,000 in these top level categories, like this tools and home improvement, home and kitchen, the major categories, that is really, really solid. It means it's selling very well. So that's what it's all about, guys. Online arbitrage versus retail arbitrage. They're both great methods that you can start as soon as today with as little as $100. You don't need a ton of capital. You don't need a ton of experience. And be sure that if you do get into these methods, that you're going to be finding hot selling products using the best seller rank. You don't want to buy a bunch of stuff that is over a million sales rank or over 700,000 or 500,000 sales rank, because those things are going to take forever to sell. That means your money's going to be stuck in that product for a lot longer, versus a product that with a lot lower bestseller rank like this one, you may be able to list it and get a sale by the end of the day. Today, okay? So that's the point, guys. I hope this helped you understand the differences between retail arbitrage and online arbitrage. If you have more questions about online arbitrage, be sure to check out my channel. There's tons and tons of videos that cover different aspects of this business. If you enjoyed this content, be sure to subscribe to this channel. Click the like button down below if you liked it. And if you have any questions, be sure to leave a comment for me down below. If you have questions, I'm sure some other person has the same question as you. So I'd love to help you out with that. Be sure to leave a comment below and subscribe. I'll see you guys on the next video. Have a good one.